Welcome to Speakertunity Sessions number 6. Speakertunity is the tip sheets that bring you direct contacts that get you booked on speaking engagements, radio shows, podcasts, and virtual summits. And this event is sponsored by Speakertunity, and we are delighted to have you here. I want to introduce you to my wonderful guest today, Iman Agai, who's a serial entrepreneur, best-selling author, and international speaker. He founded Success Road Academy in 2010, which is one of the largest information marketing centers training centers in the world. He harnesses the power of the internet and combines it with effective in-person marketing to help business owners grow their companies and professionals position themselves as the go-to experts in their fields. Also, he's the creator of Ultimate Course Formula, which is what we're going to be talking about today, which helps experts create and sell online courses with a simple step-by-step process in 60 days or less. Iman's students have founded online courses in almost every niche market, including overcoming anxiety, living a happy life, managing personal finances, being a great public speaker, weight loss and other health programs, and many, many more. Iman has worked with more than 15,000 business owners in the past few years in his seminars, events, webinars, coaching programs, and one-on-one coaching sessions. So I'm delighted to have you here today, Iman. And I want to just welcome you to Speakertunity Sessions.
Yeah, thank you very much, Jackie, for having me here, and super exciting to be here with you guys.
So tell us how you got started in this business, if you wouldn't mind.
Well, that's a very interesting kind of a loaded question in a way, because I actually didn't start as a course creator. In fact, I always wanted to become an international professional public speaker, and with that dream, I moved to Canada, and at the time that I moved to Canada, I wasn't able to speak English properly. We didn't have any family or friends or network here, and when my wife and I moved here, we just had one dream, and that dream was becoming an international professional public speaker. And so we knew that we have kind of an uphill battle at the beginning until find our way. But as we landed here a few days later, we realized that on top of all of the other problems that we had, our money is not going to follow us either. And so that caused a ton of issues. I started looking for jobs day after day after day until I got to a day that I was 17 days away from becoming homeless with my wife. Mm. And on that day, I decided to take the leap and start our business. And I thought, well, the best thing that people would pay for is, and I know how to do, is designing websites. So I started a web design company, and luckily enough, 3 days later, I found my first client, and that client's payment was $1,800, which paid for the rent and the food of that month. And I continued building a web design company until one day I ended up on my deathbed. And one morning I woke up, I was bleeding internally out of the blue. I was rushed to the hospital, and doctors realized I've lost 60% of my blood. And they couldn't find the source of the bleeding, so they couldn't stop it. And I was literally bleeding dry. And as I was lying on my deathbed, like waiting to either die or survive, I realized I haven't lived my life true to my purpose, and I'm dying with so many regrets. And I didn't want to die a web designer. I wanted to inspire people. I wanted to help people. I wanted to support a lot of people. And yet, because of finances, I was continuing doing web design. And after that day, when I got out of hospital, my bleeding stopped just out of the blue on its own. And I was released from the hospital. And I started doing public speaking. And I started sharing my message and knowledge. And use that to grow my business. But in 2014, I was doing so many talks. I was doing about 200 talks a year. And I was traveling from one city to another city. I was 280 pounds, didn't have the time to do any exercises, living out of hotel rooms. Hadn't seen my wife for like 3 to 4 months at the time, at times. And then I knew that I need to find a way that I can keep sharing my knowledge and message, but without being personally involved, without I wanted to have a way to share my knowledge and message, have financial freedom, but at the same time I was looking for something that gives me location freedom and time freedom. So I could be wherever I want to be, I could do whatever I want to do, and at the same time share my knowledge and message and make money. And so that in 2014 led us in starting creating and selling online courses. And today I have over 44 online courses. We have 15,000 students in our programs and in our training series, and you know, just kind of life is very different. So still I travel, but but we travel for pleasure. Sometimes I travel for speaking because speaking is my passion. You know, it's not something that I that is gone away. Just doing 200 of it a year was too much. So I still go on like big stages. I choose the stage I want to talk at, and I still speak. But then, as I said, I speak on the stages that I'm passionate about. Like I spoke at TEDx Stanley Park, which had absolutely nothing to do with my business. It was on the story of what changed in me when I ended up on my deathbed, and how you can live a life without any regrets. In front of 2,000 people, and that video has been watched by 310,000 people or something more.
Wow. I can't believe how much courage it took to come here to want to be a public speaker when you didn't even speak the language.
And yeah,
and really you know, through all this.
And I know, like, because like we are on a speaker community, right? Like people have this burning desire in their hearts that they want to become a speaker. Like we look at speakers and we're like, I want to be that, or I can be better than that. You know, and so yeah, so anyhow, so that's so, how.
Yeah, obviously the people on this who are watching have a burning desire to deliver their message too, so we're in the right place today.
Absolutely.
So yeah. Why did you decide to create and sell the online courses and really focus in that area?
Yeah, as I said, like I was looking for something that that would give me financial freedom, but at the same time, location freedom and time freedom, right? I remember the exact moment that I made that decision. I was in Toronto, which is 3 hours ahead from Vancouver, and it was 8 a.m. Toronto time, which is 5 a.m. My body time, right? And we were setting up for a two-day event, which was on how to live a life true to your purpose. And I was standing on the stage and looking for a pen. And there was this box of pen in front of me. And in my mind, I was thinking, oh, I need a pen. This is a box of pen. Oh, I need a pen. This is a box of pen. And I couldn't connect the two. And I froze on the stage for 10 minutes. And that's how tired I was. And I realized I'm not fit to lead that seminar anymore. And I was doing what I was passionate about, but I was not living my life true to my purpose. So I went to the back of the room and told my team, guys, I can't lead this event. So they panicked. I said, oh, I'm going to go upstairs. And I got to regroup. I got to think. And I went upstairs to my hotel room, laid on the bed, put my feet on the wall, and I asked myself two questions. What do I like about my life? And what do I hate about my life? And I really recommend this to everyone. If you haven't done this recently, do this. Ask yourself these two questions. Because these two questions are the two questions that change your life. And I came with this that I like the fact that I'm sharing my knowledge and message. I like the fact that I'm changing people's lives. I like the fact that like I'm helping so many people, and I like the fact that I have financial security, but I was looking for something that I can help more people at the same time gives me freedom that I can do the things that I meant to do in my life, right? And so that was the starting point, the mindset point. And then at that point, anyhow, I got new energy and I went downstairs. I did that event. But then when we came back to Vancouver, I canceled every other event that we have, like all other events that we have. I canceled every single one of them. I gave myself 3 months to figure out a way, or the best way, to replace our strategy with something else. And the best strategy, hands down, that we found between all the strategies that we could use was creating online courses and selling online courses. Now, I still do live events, as I said, and I still do 3-day live events now, but then the leading program into those live events are an online course. So technically, one of the benefits that we have in online courses is that we use online courses as a qualified lead generation system. So it brings quality leads to us on a regular basis. And I know many people who are on the call today, because when people have knowledge, there are a lot of people who go to them and say, hey, you know, you have this awesome knowledge. Can I get this advice from you for free? Right? Can I get this advice for you? And they never want to pay for it, right? And so we use our courses to filter people who are just interested comparing to people who actually want to commit and do the work and get the results. And at the same time, they want to financially invest in themselves with you.
And the kinds of courses we're talking about, they go from what price to what price? I mean, you know, what are you really looking at here?
A really great question. So, you know, there are lots of courses out there that are inexpensive, like they're $20, $30, $50, $100. And those are totally okay, but those are not the courses that I'm personally interested in. Like, I like them because they create an automated stream of income, and we have a few of those, which is cool to wake up to some money every morning without, you know, doing anything in a way. But one part that I really focus on is on creating result-oriented courses. And the result-oriented courses are courses that gets, like, you work closer with people, you help them to get results. There are a little bit deeper programs, but at the same time, they are more expensive. And those courses, depending on the niche market, may start anywhere from $300-$500 and go all the way to $100,000. Now, the more you add to those programs, so one of the misconceptions when it comes to online courses is that a lot of people think that an online course is just series of recorded videos and audios, and definitely they are a part of online courses, but they are not the only thing that goes to an online course. You have several other things you can include in an online course, like live group coaching classes. Same thing as you and I are doing right now, but in a format that everybody sees each other, everybody can chat with each other, and go through a training. The other ways is like doing live webinars when people can ask their questions in the chat box and one person teaches. You can also include some one-on-one online training. So, and obviously the more you add, the more expensive it becomes, right? Like for example, my Rising Star Experts Mentorship Program is $39,000 and is entirely online. So, but it includes 26 one-on-one sessions with me, 26 one-hour one-on-one sessions with me. It also includes lots of our other smaller online courses and access to a Facebook group that people can ask their questions. So it gives people support. It takes people's hand and walk them through step by step. And obviously, it's more expensive. Or, for example, our lead program is $12,500. Like, one of the versions of it is $12,500 upfront. Another version of it is $19,000 upfront. And those programs don't have any one-on-ones with me. They are entirely online. They are entirely in the group format. But they are more in specific about getting a specific result. So when people invest $12,500 on a lead program, they know that they are creating their funnels. They know that they're running their ads toward that funnels. They know that they get support during that year that they are part of the program, and they launch and they sell, right? So people are investing in programs, and that's the mindset shift that if you get when it comes to creating online courses will help you massively, right? That people are not buying a course from you. People are investing in their own success with your course. And if you have this massive mindset shift that I'm not creating a course just for people to buy, I'm creating a course so people can invest in so they can get the results with me. And then that's the time that you overcome that fear of, oh my God, like there are so many competitors out there. Oh my God, there are so many other courses out there, right? Like for example, one of my students, her name is Ara Gonzalez, and she teaches yoga. And when she started creating the online course with me, like the first session that she had, she was talking about creating this $15 yoga training videos. And I asked her, why do you want to create $15 yoga training videos, right? And she said, because there are so many great YouTube trainings on yoga, and they're all free. And if they're all free, how can I create a course more than $15? And I said, are those courses result-oriented? Are those courses helping people to get the best results from yoga that they want? And she said, not really, like they're just recorded videos. And I said, so how can you create a result-oriented course? And we went through my formula, which is called the Ultimate Course Formula. It's an 8-step process. And within the first 4 weeks, people create an irresistible result-oriented offer. Because everybody, first of all, like as soon as I say this, people say, oh my God, like, well, I don't have anything in my mind. And you're not supposed to have anything in your mind like at the moment. I mean, some people have some ideas, some people don't, right? But when you begin this journey, you are not supposed to have the idea. If you have the idea, good for you. But if you don't, you are not any different than the people who have. Because even if you have the idea, you had to validate the idea. I mean, validate the idea with a very specific type of market research, not the market research that you find on the internet, like go Google. Like, no, it's a specific 8-question market research that you need to get on the phone and do that. But then when you go through that market research, you find that irresistible offer that people want to invest in. And so she found that offer, and it was a $2,500 yoga training. And she put that together. And within the first 8 weeks, she sold $27,000 worth of her offer. And so... the perspective there is that she had a $67 per month offer and a $2,500 offer, and not a single person bought the $67 per month offer. Not a single person. Why? Because every single one of those people who were investing in their programs, they were investing in their health, they were investing in their success. And so they didn't want to beat around the bush or like just kind of play with their health. They wanted to get results and get over their problems, their pains, right? So when you create a result-oriented course, and $2,500 yoga training, by the way, is very expensive yoga training, even if you go to a studio and get a $2,500 yoga training, right? Let alone having an online training for $2,500. But that's when you create a result-oriented course, that's the time that people are willing to invest. And the other side of that, I just want to say, the other side of that, imagine the $67 per month, how many courses had she sold, or like she had to sell to be able to cover $27,000?
Yeah. Right? Well, I had the privilege of meeting Ara when I met you initially in January of this last year. And trust me, she was glowing and singing your praises because she had developed this whole new perspective on life about what her future was going to be. So I congratulate both of you on that success. And I know you've had that with so many other people's. So how fast can a person build an online course?
Well, okay. So on a regular basis, I have an 8-step process called the Ultimate Course Formula. By the way, that those of you who are on the call today, you can get access to that, and you can get an overview of exactly what those steps are. Jackie and I are going to give you a link that you can actually get that training. It's on a webinar that you can attend tomorrow at noon or 6 p.m. So you can give yourself the time to go and overview those 8 steps. But if a person follow those 8 steps and do one step at a time, and just focus on getting that step done and doesn't skip any steps. So just follow those steps, focus on one step at a time, and doesn't skip any steps. If a person does that and spend about 4 productive hours every week, now some people get the 4 productive hours done in 10 hours, some people get it done in 4 hours, right? But 4 productive hours every week, a person can finish their course in about 8 weeks. Now, that isn't including recording of the content of the course, because one of the techniques that I teach is live recording. And with a live recording, technically you are recording as you teach. And so when you record as you teach, then your course, if your course is like 12 weeks, then your course takes 12 weeks to record. But you're recording only like 1 hour a week, which is really easy to do. But the important part that comes to the picture is to create a course that actually people want to invest on and people actually want to buy. And that process takes 4 weeks, and then the next 4 weeks you sell the course, you get students into the program, and you launch your course, and then you start recording the course. So generally in about 8 weeks, a course can be created, launched, sold, and get started on training. Now, depending on how long the course is, the course may take like 10 weeks or 4 weeks or 3 weeks, but technically it's your course, so you're teaching it. So
you, this is kind of almost second nature to you. What's the fastest time you've ever done one of these?
Okay, so the fastest time that I've done this is in 48 hours while I was attending a 3-day event, and it was a challenge actually. So on the first day of the event, I was challenged, like it was a fun challenge, it was a fun event, like we're at the mastermind, 6-7 figure business owners, like mastermind sessions, we're getting together. And I was talking about the online courses and how easy it is to create an online course, and you don't need to use your own knowledge, and you don't need to invest anything and stuff. And I was challenged. I was challenged to build a course in 48 hours while we were at the event without me teaching it, without using any of my resources that I have from the past, without investing a dime on it, right? And I had to create and sell it within 48 hours. So it was a fun challenge. And what I did, I exactly followed the same steps of Ultimate Course Formula, but I just followed them fast, right? So I went online the first, like, because I was not supposed to teach it either, right? I was not supposed to use any of the resources that I had. So the only thing I was allowed to use, like, my regular Facebook, which everybody has access to, right? My regular webcam, which everybody has access to, but nothing expensive, no lighting, no studio setup, nothing. So with that, I actually went to my Facebook and to my Facebook personal Facebook profile, and I said, guys, I want to create a course for entrepreneurship. What's your most important questions that you have about entrepreneurship? And people started asking their questions, and I started composing all the questions that people want to get answered. And as we were at the event, I started thinking about, okay, how can I create more fun? Like, I can create something good about this. So I said, any money that comes from this course is going to be donated to build the schools. So I put this message out and said, I'm creating this course, and if you are interested to learn this information from some world-class leaders, just comment below that you want the course. And we call that building your beta group list. So I started building my beta group list of people who are interested in investing in the course, right? And then I got these questions, and I was at the conference, right? So I went to these people who were at the conference. They were like successful business owners. And I said, can you get in front of camera and answer these 7 questions for me? And they said, yeah, absolutely. So I gave them the questions, and they got in front of the camera. I had my Logitech C920, which is a $65 camera. Like, you can use your own laptop camera as well, like, not a big deal, right? I got in front of that. I put them in front of the camera, and they answered the questions, and I recorded the content. So I recorded the content with 12 people who were at the event, and I uploaded them to a software called Thinkific. Now, Thinkific's point is that it is Thinkific, like scientific, but Thinkific, right? So, and Thinkific.com. Now, one of the things about that site is that Thinkific allows you to create a membership site for free, right? And I was not supposed to spend a dime to create my course. So, and I love Thinkific. Like, I think it's one of the best platform, like, and not one of them, it's just the best platform that is out there to create online courses. Well, you can upgrade and you can have a paid plan with them as well. But then I was supposed to not to spend a dime. So I uploaded everything to Thinkific, put together my sales page based on what people had told me when I did the market, when I went to Facebook and asked people what they want to learn, right? And based on that, I put together the sales page. And within 39 hours, we launched the course. And I slept and woke up in the morning to $500 sold in the course. And I messaged personally everyone who said they are interested in buying this course, right? So so within 48 hours, I created the course, launched the course, sold the course, and we donated the money to build the schools. But yeah, that was but it's exact same 8 steps. It's the exact same 8 steps that we teach at the Ultimate Course Formula. I followed the exact same thing, but just I followed it in a faster way.
Spell again the platform you use. Think.
Thinkific.
Okay. I just posted it to everybody.
Perfect. Yeah. Thinkific.com. And yeah, so, as I said, Thinkific, I'm having a webinar with them later today, and they're actually the technical support of my course. Just kind of like there are so many platforms out there and that they get people confused and all of those type of things. And Thinkific is very, very easy to use and to implement and set up. Technically, you can have your landing page and your entire course. If you have your content ready within like less than 60 minutes, you can put together your entire program. To set up your account takes only 3 minutes.
Wow, that's impressive. Thank you for that information.
Yeah, absolutely. By the way, Thinkific is not the only membership platform that I use, but it's the one that I always recommend to people to use because it has the least amount of technical difficulties.
We like that.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. So that's why I really like it, and it allows you to create your sales page there. It allows you to create landing pages there. You can almost have a complete website by using Thinkific, and so. Yeah, so I highly recommend it.
Thank you. That's really very cool. Appreciate that. So can you break down some of the most common mistakes that people make when it comes to creating their online courses?
Yes. Trying to go after everything all together at the same time. So one of the things that we do as entrepreneurs is that we have a tendency of getting ourselves overwhelmed and then thinking, oh my God, I'm too overwhelmed, I cannot do anything. So when it comes to creating your online course, one of the things I want to say is that first, do one thing at a time and don't get yourself worried about things that are not relevant to today. For example, many people who start creating their course, right away they are thinking, oh, if I create this course, who is going to buy it? Where am I going to get the traffic? What's going to, how my sales page is going to look like? Those are future worries, right? Now, you got to pay attention to them, paying attention to them is not your first step. The first step that you need to follow is to understand how your business is going to benefit from online courses. And there are several ways that you can benefit from an online course. And it's not just like creating a course and putting it out there for $20 and that's it. There are far more benefits to online courses. And so the first step is understanding how your online course that you're about to create is going to impact your business. And you need to know that many people when they're starting, they always think about creating only one course and they try to put everything in one course. But the reality is that if you look at world-class leaders, none of us have only one course. I have 44 courses. I didn't wake up saying that, oh, I need to create 44 courses, but when you create, but you create one course about one specific challenge, you focus on one specific challenge, one specific problem, and you help people to overcome that specific challenge and problem, and those people need another support or another course or another challenge to work on, because now they are different. Now they have been, they have gotten some education, have gone through some training. Now they have different challenges. So now they need another support or system. So when you are creating a course, make sure that you are focused on one specific challenge, one specific problem, and don't get yourself overwhelmed with all of the processes. There are these 8 processes that when you follow every step and you do them right, you can create your course really, really fast. But the problem starts when people try to be fast. So to be fast, they try to skip steps. And when they try to skip steps, it slows them down. And that's one of the biggest problems that when it comes to creating online courses, people have, is that they get themselves overwhelmed, so they don't know where to start, and then they try to do a little bit of here, a little bit of there, and then they try to create a course that responds to everybody's needs, instead of creating one specific course for one specific group of people, and then help those people to achieve the results, and then creating another course for another group of people.
Cool, thank you. So what are the most important benefits of online courses that many people don't even take advantage of?
Yeah, absolutely. Actually, great question, by the way. So when it comes to an online course, one of the things that always people think when it comes to creating their course, they think, I want to create a course because I am tired of teaching, or I want some money coming. Like, that's generally like the mindset when a person goes through creating an online course. However, one of the things to realize is that your online course can be the foundation of attracting higher paying customers to you. Okay. So to explain that, actually, can I share my screen? Like, can I use a whiteboard?
Yes, you can. Go ahead and
so, like, do a little bit. Sorry, I'm a trainer. I gotta do this.
That's fine.
So when it comes to your course, you see my screen, right?
Right now we're seeing white. I'm waiting for it to come in. Now we're seeing
box. So when it comes to your business, you have 3 levels of customers. Okay. And the first group of your customers are called interested people, okay? And like, for example, let's say you're teaching weight loss, and you can help people to lose their weight. And there are 10,000, 20,000 people, like almost anybody you see, comes to you and say, hey, you know, I really am interested about learning, you know, how I can lose weight. And you're like, oh, okay, so great. And they're like, oh, can we sit together for a coffee? Can I take you out and just... And then what happens is that they want to take you out, they want to sit with you, they want to get some free information. They're not going to ever implement any of that information that they learn from you. But they took 1 or 2 hours of your time and kind of wasted your time because you thought they are potential customers, right? There are a ton of these interested people out there. But you cannot avoid, like, talking to these people, because between those interested people, there are a few qualified people. And who are the qualified people? The qualified people are the people who say, you know, I'm willing to put my hand in my pocket and pay you for the service that you do and do the work to get the results. And so you cannot get access to qualified people if you don't talk to interested people, because all qualified people are also interested. Right? And then between those qualified people, there are some people who are extremely committed and they are willing to heavily invest in themselves with you, both financially and time-wise. They are willing to do everything that it takes to get the results, to work and to achieve that amazing results that your dream clients should receive. And so they heavily invest financially. So to get to these groups of people, when you are doing one-on-one work, it's really hard. It's really challenging. And the fastest and most effective way that you can qualify people between interested people, or you can find the committed people between the qualified people, is by using your online courses. So instead of going out with people to have coffee meetings with them, instead of getting on the phone with every single person one-on-one, to speak with every single person one-on-one, instead of all of those type of things, you create a course for interested people. So when a person comes to you and says, hey, I'm interested in what you do, you say, well, that's fantastic. Here is a free webinar that you can watch that explains to you like what I do, that explains to you how you can achieve the goal that you have, right? Or here is a free course, here is a free training that you can study that teaches you what you want to do. So now you skip the coffee meeting, right? Now you saved like 2-3 hours of your time. But on top of that, if that person is a person who is actually willing to invest the time, they're going to take the time to study that half hour video, or they're willing to invest that time to study that short course or watch that 1.5 hour webinar, right? Now, if they're willing to do that and they are willing to invest, at the end of that webinar, at the end of that course, you invite them to invest in an inexpensive, maybe let's say $500, $1,000, like a inexpensive, not super expensive, not a $20,000 course, right? A $500, $1,000 course. And if they are really qualified people, they are willing to invest on that program because they want to get results. And when they invest in that program, then you can get in touch with them and say, hey, you know, you invested in this program. Do you like to work closely with each other and let me take your hand and walk you every step of the way, or do you want to do it on your own? Right? And if they say no, I want to do it by myself, then they do it by themselves. And so in a way, sometimes we call this done by you, right? And so they study it and they do it by themselves, and sometimes we call this done with you. Or another level of that is done for you, right? And so obviously the done with you is more expensive than done by you, and done for you is more expensive than both of them, right? Now, if you notice, what I created, what I recreated is your business, but entirely online and entirely automated. So now, you don't need to get on the phone. You don't need to get on the stage. And that's what we replaced in my business. Because before, in the past, I used to go around. I used to get on the stage. I used to talk to a lot of interested people. And between those interested people, like 10% of them or 15% of them were people who were willing to put their hand in the pocket and really invest. And they were qualified. But for me to find enough number of qualified people in our business, I had to do a lot of talks, right, to get in front of a lot of interested people. And so that's what we replaced in the business, that now, instead of me going out and doing all of that, those things, now we use our online courses, we use our webinars. We're like, okay, so here is the core concept and the training for you if you are interested to learn about how to do this specific thing. And then, if you are really interested, if you really want to do this, let's work together. And here is the training and working together. We give you everything you want to do that and achieve your goal. But if you want us also work with you hand in hand and very closely, you can go to another level and work with us very closely and hand in hand. So that's when it comes to your business. You got to look at your business and see what are the benefits. What are the benefits of online courses? How are you going to use courses to attract interested people, qualified people, and committed people? And as I said, by the way, that's the first step. That's the first step. Today, like I'm going to actually ask this from everybody on this call today. It's like, which group of people do you need the most in your business today? Do you need people who are interested? Because you don't have a mailing list, because you are not known in the market. And if you are not known, if you don't have mailing list, if you're getting started, you need to get in touch with a lot of interested people and educate them to find the qualified people, right? So do you need the interested people or no? You are known in the market, you have the systems, but now you have to create a course that generates automated stream of income for you. And the automated stream of income comes from the qualified courses, right? This is entirely, anything goes toward the qualified courses mostly are automated. You are not personally involved, they are automated. Or you're looking for more committed people, like high-end courses, expensive, $10,000, $20,000, $50,000. And then you're serving people very closely with excellence, still online, still you're working from wherever you want, right? I've taught my course when I've been in Paris, I've taught my courses when I've been in Germany, I've taught my course when I've been in Caribbean, right? Like, you can teach your course anywhere that you want. This is still an online course. But you are getting paid for it really well, and you are delivering results to people, right? So which one do you want? And another thing, by the way, Jackie, when it comes to that, is that one of the benefits of online courses is that you can bundle online courses with each other to create higher value courses. Right? So when a person invests $39,000 with me in my mentorship program, they get access to all of my online courses. That's a ton of value there.
You said there were how many?
44. Right? So they have some overlap, so they get about 20, but there are 44 online courses. They get access to 20, but like we remove the overlapped parts, right? So they get access to all of those online courses, plus they get 26 one-on-one sessions with me. So in a way, for the amount of work that I personally put in, I'm getting paid about $1,500 an hour. But nobody is paying me $1,500 an hour. Because when people are investing $39,000, they're not investing just in the one-on-ones with me. They're investing in one-on-ones and all of the trip, all of the courses and all of the events, and all of those type of things. But my personal engagement is only 26 hours.
Wow, that's impressive.
So that's what I want you to realize, that with using your online course, you can create this amazing high value to get really paid well for every single hour of your time without being personally involved. And that is the biggest benefit when it comes to creating online courses. And many people just simply forget and disregard that.
Wow, that's really something. You know, the fact that it can be a beautiful pathway to your high-end client, it gives you the freedom that you really want.
Yeah.
So, you know, what kind of tools do you use to do this besides of Thinkific?
Yeah, okay. So Thinkific is one of the tools that I use, obviously, and we usually use it for putting together the membership area. The other tool that I really like is ClickFunnels. And the reason for ClickFunnels is two things. Number one, to our students in Ultimate Course Formula, I actually give them my funnel, so they can actually copy my entire system. One of the things that I like to do is I like to give people things that actually work today. Unfortunately, there are lots of not really good information in the online marketing world of people who say, hey, you know, come and do this, but they are doing totally different thing and they're making money somewhere else, but they tell people that come and do this that they are not making money from, right? And I'm personally tired of that. So one of the things I do is that when I'm working with my students, I give them the exact system that I use that I'm making money with today. And I say, here is the way I'm making money with today. And so copy it and use it in your own business, okay? And so one of the reasons I like ClickFunnels is because I can literally give my funnels to my students with a click of a button. So they click on it, it copies my entire funnel to their system, and they can easily customize it and manage it. And when you learn how to use ClickFunnels, which takes about like maybe half a day to become really good at using it, if you're good with technology, maybe takes you like 30 minutes. But if you're not good with technology, it may take you up to half a day to learn how to use it properly. And then that can help a lot big time. And the other thing I like is our setup in the studio right now. So when it comes to creating your course, you may want to use a good camera, you may want to use a good microphone, but at the same time, you don't want to break the bank, which is very easy when it comes to cameras and microphones to do. So the camera that I'm using is called Logitech C920. Also, there are...
392?
C, zero? C920.
C920.
Right. So the ones that I'm using right now is Logitech C920. There is a newer version of this called C930. So, and there is another one, C928. The reality is that any of these cameras would work because C920, the one that I'm using right now, broadcasts, this one broadcasts 1080 HD, which is the highest quality you want to broadcast online. So if you buy C930, it gives you a higher quality, but you can't use it online. So wouldn't matter really if you get this or the other one. What I like about this camera is it has a good microphone and it has a good quality, and it's only C920 is only $65 right now, and on a $65 camera, it records all the information directly to your computer, so you don't need to transfer the files, you don't need to edit the files. You just transfer them to your computer and you upload them online, which is actually great. Also, the microphone that I like to use is called the Yeti Blue. So it's a great quality microphone. It's the one that I'm using right now, and I'm using it on an arm, so it's actually right here. And this is Yeti Blue. It's a little bit bulky, but then it records very high quality sound and allows you to do a lot of different things when it comes to creating your course or putting it in the middle of an event and record high quality audio from an event as well. And then the lighting, what I use is softbox lighting. They are bulky, like softbox lightings are pretty bulky.
Softbox?
Softbox, yes. Softbox lighting. And you can use also LED lighting, which is much smaller than these that I'm using. And technically behind me is just a white wall that we painted it just white. And that's that. Or you can have a very good looking, you know, background or same place as Jackie is sitting, like a nice looking, you know, neat area behind you, and just create your course. But one thing to remember is this: people care about your content and the results that they get from your course. That's what people care about. Don't worry about how you look on camera. Don't worry about your lighting. Don't worry about your microphone. Don't worry. Like, all of those things are good, okay, to have. However, they don't make any impact in how much of your course you sell. You know why? Because people don't see those until they have bought the course. First, people buy the course, then they see how your videos look like, then they see how your audios look like. Now, I'm not saying that create crappy videos. I'm not in any shape or form saying that, right? But what I'm saying is that focus on your content and teach people great content and focus on changing people's lives, because that's the time that people invest on your courses. That's the time that they start taking action, that's the time that they change their lives, and that's the time that they refer clients to you on a regular basis.
Thank you. That's great information. I know we all worry about how we present ourselves, but it's really so much more in terms of what you're delivering. So thank you. That's fabulous. So we're going to take some questions, but in the meantime, and if you have any, put them either in the chat box or the Q&A. But in the meantime, Aman, would you like to give us a little bit about how they can learn more about this? And
Yeah, absolutely. So what I recommend is that today, because of the timing, like Jackie and I were speaking yesterday, and I looked at the timing, and there is no way that I could go through the 8-step process, like every single step, and explain it to you. And it's the core of like the creating of your online course. And I really like to share that with you. Jackie has a link for you guys that is gonna leave in the chat box. And just go to that link and register for a webinar tomorrow at noon or at 6 p.m. and attend that webinar where I will teach how to create your courses through these 8-step process. So I'll explain every single step, and I'll tell you what to do in the step. And another thing, a bonus on top of that, is that when you stay to the very end of that webinar, I'll also give you an ebook. It's a 35-page ebook on every single tool. Like, I mean, like every single tool you need to create and sell your online courses and build your funnels. Anything from your affiliate tracking software, from mailing list building softwares, from the design tools, from how to get graphics really well, like how to get good graphics, how to create 3D graphics, how to get content really well put together, how to record your screens. Like, there are lots of things like that. And so I spent over $50,000 on buying the wrong tools and investing on the wrong people to implement them for me until I came up with this list of 35 pages of the right tools to use. And you probably need only like 3 or 4 of them, but then we give you options there, and I it's a full report on every tool that is out there that you can use. And so I highly recommend attend the webinar tomorrow, sign up for it, and either attend at noon or 6 p.m. and go through that, learn the process. And if you are interested in the program, you are more than welcome to join the program, obviously. And I'm more than happy to support you in the program as well. All of that information is on the webinar tomorrow.
So I'm going to say what this, the URL for this is tinyurl.com/speakertunity-success-road, as in his company Success Road Academy. So I'm going to repeat that again, tinyurl.com/speakertunity-success-road. Now, if people were to come in and watch this replay, would they be able to access that and begin at any time that they would like to?
Yeah, absolutely. So that's an ongoing webinar that's happening every day at like every time that you go there. There's a webinar happening tomorrow at noon at 6 p.m. And and there's information, everything about the course. So whether you're watching the recording or you're watching this live, that training is there for you. I highly recommend it. That webinar has changed the lives of so many people. And by the way, make sure that you take a pen and paper. You're going to probably take about 15 pages of notes. Like, I've been told by people that they took 15 pages of notes within that 90 minutes. So you definitely want to make sure that you have a pen and paper.
What a wonderful gift. Thank you, Iman. That's really lovely.
Thanks. My pleasure.
And for anybody that has come in late, this interview is also going to be accessible on speakertunity.com on the Speakertunity Sessions tab on the website. So you can also watch the beginning if you came in late. So just asking if anybody else has any questions. And in the meantime, Iman, if there's any other information you want to impart, feel free.
So I just want to say something, just to put this out there. If you have a knowledge and message and you aren't sharing it, you are causing a lot of lives to have problems, because your knowledge and message can help a lot of people's lives. And you have this responsibility as a person who has the knowledge to teach this knowledge to people to change their lives. And when you stop yourself and you don't take action and you don't put that message out, you are hurting yourself and you are hurting those people that you could help. It's your responsibility. It's your, it's what you deserve as a person who has the knowledge to live the lifestyle of a person who has successful courses. And at the same time, it's your responsibility to support people and help them. And those people deserve to live a better life. And don't keep your knowledge to yourself. Get out there, share your message, share your knowledge, and lead people, right? That's why I always wear a t-shirt that says I'm a leader, because that's what I highly believe, that that we have either leaders who go out there and change people's lives, or we have people who are best kept secret in the market, and by keeping their knowledge and content in their heart, they are hurting themselves and they're hurting everybody else around them. So this is actually part of one of the things that all of my students actually wear, by the way. If you ever hang out with anybody from Success for the Academy and of our students, you see that, like, for example, you may go somewhere, you see 20 people wearing I'm a Leader t-shirt. That's like all of our students wear their I'm a Leader t-shirts when we're hanging out together. So hi. And so, yeah, so just get out there, share your knowledge, share your message. You and the people that need your services deserve to live a better life.
Thank you. That was a beautiful, beautiful comment to end on. And we're about at the end of the hour and we don't have any additional questions. So thank you, Iman, for joining us today. This was wonderful. It was enlightening. Thanks for that great course that you're offering for folks to experience. And I look forward to staying in touch and bringing you to our community again in the future.
My pleasure. Thank you very much for having me, and looking forward to seeing all of you on the webinar that we have going on tomorrow. Thanks.
Thank you. Take care.